Hello students, well how are you? Now students, let's continue with the chapter. The name is From Trade to Territory. Okay, and so far students, we have discussed and we have read that the Battle of Plassey was fought between Siraj-ud-Daulah and the British, and in that battle who lost the power? Siraj-ud-Daulah. Okay, he was assassinated, means he was killed, he was murdered. And after that, who became the king of Bengal? Mir Jafar. Okay, earlier we have read it. Then what happened when Mir Jafar refused to help the British? What happened? The British, they made Mir Qasim as the Nawab of Bengal. Again what happened? Mir Qasim refused. Then again Mir Jafar was reinstalled as the Nawab of Bengal. But by that time Mir Jafar, he said that you just have trade, but you do not want, or you don't want to be the master of Bengal. So Mir Jafar died in 1765. Okay, and now by that time the company, he wanted to take over Bengal. Okay, this earlier we have read about all these things. Now let's just move further, and now let's see that company officials. Now students, officials is means rank, highest rank. Company officials become Nawab. Nawab means just behave like Rajas. Okay, what did it mean to be Nawab? Now what is the meaning of Nawab? It means that the company acquired means get, hasil karna, more power and authority. But it also meant something else, means each company servant, here company servant means company officer, began to have vision, means wanted to be or to live like Nawabs, like Rajas. So now what they did for that, just to behave themselves like Rajas, what they did? Now let's see. Now students, after the Battle of Plassey, the actual Nawab of Bengal, actual means in real sense, who were the Nawab of Bengal, were forced to give land, means to give their land and vast sum means huge amount of money as personal gift. Means they were forced to give large amount of money as gift to company officials. Now see how surprisingly that a king is to give money as personal gift. Robert Clive himself, amazed a fortune means I mean to say that very lucky in India, he had come to Madras, now we call it as Chennai, from England in 1743 at the age of 18, so early. When in 1767 he left India, his Indian fortune means money was worth means sum of $4,01,102. You see, in 1767 how just much rich he was, he became. Interestingly, when he was appointed governor of Bengal in 1764 after the Battle of Buxar, he was asked to remove corruption in company administration, but he was himself cross-examined, means he was very corrupt. He did many wrong things in 1772 by the British Parliament, because he earned a huge amount of money, he collected a huge amount of money although he was acquitted, but he committed suicide in 1774. However, not all company officials succeeded in making money. But all the company officials, means all the highest officers, they could not just earn such a large amount of money as Robert Clive earned. Even many died an early death in India due to disease. You know, students, India's climate is different and Britain's climate is different. So they could not just live here very peacefully or just healthy, and they died due to disease and war, even because they were to fought several wars. So some of them, they died in war, and it would not be right to regard all of them as corrupt. So we cannot say that all the company officials or all the British, they were corrupt. No, and dishonest. Some were honest also. Many of them came from humble background. Humble means very polite, because they belonged to very good families, and their uppermost desire was to earn enough in India. Only they wanted to earn money. They did not want to be the master in India, and they want to return to England and lead a comfortable life. Those who managed to return with wealth led flashy lives and flaunted their riches. They were called Nawabs. Those, the people or the British officials, those who earned a large amount of money, they just led a very wealthy life, very luxurious life, and they just looked like rich people, Nawabs. That's why they called themselves as Nawab, an anglicized version of English Indian word Nawab. They were often seen as upstarts and social climbers in Britain, British society, and were ridiculed or made fun of in plays and cartoons. Now you see, after the Battle of Plassey and after the Battle of Buxar, now the company rule expanded. Expanded means the just earlier it was in Bengal and some areas only. Now it was expanded, and maximum of the states, Indian states or Indian territories or Indian regions, they were under the British rule. If we analyze the process of annexation of Indian states by the East India Company from 1757 to 1857, means almost 100 years. If we see the process means the way the British annexed means to capture Hadapna by the East India Company from 1757 to 1857, certain key aspects emerge. So we will see some main things. The company rarely launched a direct military attack on an unknown territory. First of all, the company never made direct attack on an unknown territory or unknown area. What they did? Instead, it used a variety of political, economic and diplomatic method. They did not just attack directly, but they just followed several other tactics, tricks, way out, politically, economically and very diplomatic way, means bahut dimag se, to extend its influence before annexing an Indian kingdom. Kisi kingdom ko hadapne se pehle bahut sare tarike British ne istemal kiye. After the Battle of Buxar, as earlier we discussed, in 1764, the company appointed residents in Indian states. They were political or commercial agent, means the company appointed some agents, and their job was to serve and further the interest of company. Only the these agents, what they do, what they did, they just give their services to the English officials for their betterment. Through the residents, they were known as residents, the company officials began interfering in the internal affairs of Indian states, means Indian kingdoms. Through the help of these agents, the company started interfering, means hastakshep, in the internal affairs of Indian states. They tried to decide who was to be the successor means uttaradhikari to the throne, means gaddi ka uttaradhikari kon banega, and who was to be appointed in administrative post, and who got the as the chief minister or whatever. Sometimes the company forced the states, means kingdoms, into a subsidiary alliance. I'll tell you what is the meaning of subsidiary alliance. Now it is there. According to the term of this alliance means group, Indian rulers were not allowed to have their independent armed forces. This is known as subsidiary alliance. Means no Indian king was allowed to have its own army, means own sena. They were to be protected by the company. Only company, means East India Company, will provide the army to them. But what happened? They had to pay for the subsidiary forces that the company was supposed to maintain for the purpose of this protection. Company ko unhe paisa dena padta tha army banane ke liye. Okay, if the Indian rulers failed to make the payment, then part of their territory was taken away. If any Indian ruler was unable to give the payment, then some of the area of that territory it was taken away as penalty. For example, when Richard Wellesley was the Governor General, he was a Governor General from 1798 to 1805, Governor General in India. The Nawab of Awadh was forced to give over half of his territory. Means अवध के नवाब को अपना आधा साम्राज्य कंपनी को देना पड़ा in 1801, and he failed to pay for the subsidiary alliance because he could not pay the amount for the army. Hyderabad was also forced to cede territory on similar ground. और हैदराबाद के नवाब को भी अपनी टेरिटरी का कुछ हिस्सा देना पड़ा. सो आई थिंक यू मस्ट हैव जस्ट अंडरस्टूड द थिंग्स. नाउ दिस इज ऑल फॉर टुडे. थैंक यू.